So, the Tecno Camon 18i is the most affordable of the Camon 18 series. It has some interesting specs for a device that has a starting price of 85,000 Naira. It was released a few weeks ago, and in this video, we are going to talk about everything you are supposed to know about the Camon 18i. As we know, the Camon series by Tecno is focused on camera, but does the Camon 18i take good looking pictures? Let's start by taking a look at the contents in the box. The phone comes in a silver box, and at the front, we have the Camon 18i written. Opening the box, we are greeted with the phone wrapped in plastic with some specifications highlighted. Going deeper in the box, we find the warranty card, a TPU case. We also find another smaller box that has the SIM ejector tool, micro USB cable and earpiece. Finally, we have the charger, and that's all with the contents in the box. The color I have here is called jewel blue, and I love the double color tune at the back of the device. It is made of plastic and it has a sort of matte finish that hides things to some extent. We have the fingerprint scanner at the back and it's quite responsive. Even though I would have preferred the side mounted fingerprint on this one, I still find the rear sensor secure and useful. There are triple cameras at the back and they sit in a blue glossy bump. We also have the bright quad LED flash beside the cameras. We will talk about the cameras in a bit. The phone charges via a micro USB, and honestly, that's a bummer. A USB Type-C port should be the standard by now. It has a downfiring speaker, but they are not the best. The audio coming out of the speaker is not clean. Up front, we have a camera cut out by the left, and it's noticeable even when streaming content and playing games. Screen to body ratio is 82%, but I don't think it's going to be a problem to anyone. It supports dual SIM card and also has an SD card slot. The phone feels comfortable to hold in the hand because the display is not massive. Weight distribution is also perfect, and it can be used with one hand. The display is 6.6 inch, and that's a sweet spot for the size of a display for me. If you're a part of the family here, then you know I'm not a fan of massive displays. By the way, if you're not a part of the family, subscribing to the channel will be much appreciated. Now, the resolution of the display is 720 by 1600, but it can be forgiven since we have a 90Hz refresh rate on the display. You also have the option to switch back to 60Hz or use the auto switch refresh rate that switches according to your usage. The high refresh rate basically makes scrolling faster, and it also makes the animation look better when you are gaming. The display is IPS LCD and it's not the brightest outdoors, but you can set your brightness level at Alto to get the most out of the device. It is responsive to touch and will enjoy playing games on the phone. As far as display goes, it is okay when you consider the price you are paying for. Moving away from the display, let's touch up on the operating system and performance. The phone was running on Android 11 with Tecno's iOS 7.6, but during my time with the phone, I received the Android 12 update and the new iOS 8.5.0. As usual, it comes loaded with apps, but some of them can be removed. The UI is a little bit redefined. You swipe on the left to get access to the notification shade. You swipe to the right to get access to the control center. It takes a bit of getting used to, as I forget where to swipe sometimes. The control center looks like Apple and Xiaomi had a baby. We have swipe gestures, and widgets can now be added on the home screen. Sadly, the bloatware on the phone still put notification to the phone even on the new UI. You can also activate the one-handed mode, and users with small hand will find that useful. The phone has face unlock, but I don't recommend using it because it's less secure. There are other features like game mode and app twin that lets you clone apps on the Camon 18i. The UI is refined and app icons appear smaller. I'm glad that Tecno is now pushing out software updates, and I'm sure they will keep improving their user interface. The phone is powered by the Mediatek Helio G85. It's a decent chipset that is built on a 12 nanometer processor. We have the Mali G52 MC2 as the GPU. The variant with me here has 4GB RAM and 128GB of storage. It performs well and opens apps fast. I have played games and scrolled different social media apps on the phone, and there was no issue. For the price, you have to appreciate the performance you are getting from this phone. Performance is similar to the Prover 2 that I reviewed earlier on the channel. The Tecno Camon 18i has a 5000mAh battery, and you are guaranteed a whole day usage. If you turn off the high refresh rate, you can even extend the battery life because the high refresh rate significantly drains the battery. The charger in the box charges the phone from 0 to 100 in about 2 hours. You should expect at least 7 hours of screen on time under heavy usage. The battery life is okay on this phone. We have a 48 megapixel main camera here, accompanied by a 2 megapixel depth sensor and a 2 megapixel macro camera. The main attraction here is the 48 megapixel camera, and up front we have an 8 megapixel selfie shooter and a flash. Here are some shots from the camera. The Tecno Camon 18i is a phone I would recommend for people who wish to spend below 90,000 naira for a phone. It has great battery life and performance. The 48 megapixel main camera will deliver in an environment with good light. For a price of 85,000 naira, I can recommend this ahead of the Tecno Prova 2. The biggest difference between the two will be the battery and display. Thanks for watching, and hopefully you'll stick around for my next video.